I'm pretty high right now. I took 2,100 milligrams of Phenibut around 1,900 hours, which is like 6 hours ago, so I'm in the middle of that high, and I've been smoking some weed, and I'm going to smoke a little bit more right now and just start talking. I'm feeling pretty good right now. Life is pretty good at the moment. You know, I started that new software development contract position about 2 months ago, and it's been going decent so far. I'm really, really hoping that I can stay here in Arkansas, even though they want me to move once the pandemic is over, even though people are just, you know, they're being stupid, they're not getting vaccinated, they're running around without their masks on because all the mask mandates are over. And as such, people are, as such rates are, the infection rates are climbing, especially in my state of Arkansas. There's not hardly anybody here who's vaccinated, it seems. I got my vaccines, I got both doses of the vaccine, so I'm fully vaccinated against COVID, but a lot of people in Arkansas haven't gotten their vaccines. Like over half of the population in Arkansas is unvaccinated, and nobody's wearing their masks, so maybe all the idiots will die out. That's what I'm hoping. That'd be cool, and then Arkansas can be a great state. Arkansas has a lot of potential, you know. It's pretty much untouched ground for the most part. The biggest city, Little Rock, is like 200,000 people. There's like only 3 million people. I grew up in Maryland, and that has twice the amount of people that Arkansas does now. It has like 6 million people now compared to Arkansas, which has like just over 3 million. Besides, I've got this house that's completely paid for, that I own, and it's practically perfect, even though it's a little rough around the edges. I've got some ceiling problems. Like right here in my living room, there's a big crack right here in the peak of the vaulted ceiling. Matter of fact, ceiling, like right here, you can see like all this crap, like there's cracking right there in the middle right through here, and you can see where it's been repaired in the past, even though it wasn't a great job. And yeah, there's kind of just a big crack going through the middle right there in my bedroom, or should I say the bedroom, because it's the only room with the bed. I got some nail pops going on right here. I don't think this is structural, but it's just, I'm probably going to need to get those redone. I've been hearing a lot of creaking in here lately too. I've got some little cracks that run right through there. And right here. I can kind of feel like a bulge where it just doesn't feel right. And this door shuts weird. And this door right here doesn't even shut at all. It's been like that. I've tried to plane it like right here, and I've kind of fucked the door up. probably going to replace that door, but I'm going to keep this doorknob because all the doorknobs in this house are original, like a decent portion of the house, and it is anyways. It's very true to the year 1979. Like, the ceiling fan is an original though. It was an addition to the house. Like these, I'm pretty sure like these are all original. Like all these lights are original, and that light right there is original. This light right here is original. That smoke detector is original. And matter of fact, I actually tested it with this, with the smoke detector spray today, and it went off. It still works, but I'm sure its range is shitty though. Like, I definitely should put in like another smoke detector, like right in the kitchen and all the bedrooms. Just four, I think, right here. I think over the living room might be fine, but just the bedrooms and the kitchen. And those are probably the only places I need to put some smoke detectors. Plus, I'm gonna get that fireplace taken care of. It needs to be redone. The chimney's messed up. I've got holes in it. And there's like these little refractory panels on the sides. I'm gonna get a flashlight because I can't see in the dark. Like, just notice like how bent out of shape this little panel is. Like, look at that. It's warped from like probably 42 plus years, because I'm sure those panels are original. You know, they've been there for like 42 years now. I've only owned the house for a little over a year now, and I've not used the fireplace. So, like, you know, I mean, it's been there for like over four decades. It's probably, you know, it's just old. You know, things like that have to be replaced. You know, but you know, these light fixtures, you know, these are. You know, these I don't want to replace. You know, these I think are worth, you know, taking care of and fixing if they break. Because I think they're nice, and they're pretty nice and unique looking. Even though, I mean, all the houses I've lived in, like when I was a kid, you know, these fixtures, you know, they look like they kind of look like the kinds of things I would see in houses that I grew up in. I grew up in houses like from the defining houses of my childhood were the one that I grew up in from 2001 to 2007 in Maryland, and then the one I grew up in, which is not too far from where I am now, here in Arkansas. I lived there from 2008 to 2017, though. I lived there on and off between the dorm at Euler. And there, like on and off between 2013 and 2017 when I was getting my bachelor's degree. The house in Maryland was built in 98, and the house in the house I was living in here in Arkansas, not too far from where I am. I may as well just say the same name. It's in a city called Maumelle. It's a bedroom. It's a suburban dystopian nightmare, and that was established in the 80s, which, you know, won't they go, I'd like that, but it just didn't feel like a terrific place. It was like it had no character. But older areas like where I'm at, it has a lot of character. My neighborhood is from like, the neighborhood I lived in, now I'm living in, is like, it was established in 1978. And the houses, most of the houses were from 78 through 79. Myself, my own house was built in 1979.
But it was built, houses were built in this neighborhood up until 1988. And there's, so even though the majority of the houses are from the late 70s, there's a good portion of homes here that were built in 84, 87, and 88. Why I know that, I don't know. I just kind of felt like getting to know the history of my neighborhood and envisioning what it was like to live here back in those days. Because I'm a big, those that know me well know that I really like the late 21st century, especially the 80s. I'm a very big 80s guy. I'm very big on the 80s. I've got to step into the zone in here. Shit, I might as well just turn this on. It is my 1986 ceiling fan, an antique gold brass ceiling fan from 1986, which was new in the box, and it works like a charm. I got this TV from 1987. I got all these old game consoles, my Atari 7800, and my Super Nintendo, and plenty of games to go around. I got all this old shit in this old house. It's perfectly retro. It's pretty awesome, I would say. Have my own place. And it's old school just the way I like it. The way I think it needs to be. It's pretty awesome, you know. I had a leak earlier this year, and I still need to get that little ceiling defect, that little discoloration on the ceiling done, but I'll get to it eventually. Man, I like this place a lot. I want to live here for the rest of my life. It ain't much, but you know what? It's mine. It's all mine. This is all mine. It's just perfect for my bachelor lifestyle. It's not too big, but yet not too small. It's just right for me. That's what I like about it. Anyways, may as well just end it here. I don't really have much else to say. I'm just going to sit back, relax, and enjoy this wonderful high that I've created for myself. I'm feeling good. Life is good. I have a feeling from here on out, things are only just going to keep getting better. As I get older and I get wiser, I start to realize that simple things in life really about all I need. Adiós.